Okay guys, so I literally just woke up. The time is now 8:20 and I take my test at 1 o'clock. I am gonna leave out here at like 11:30 though, just because I gotta drive like an hour and 15 minutes away just to go to the test. And I wanna be there like 15 minutes early. So I got up. Not really feeling anxious. I'm more so just like, I don't know, I feel like I've got to the point with this test where I'm just so like over it, where it's like, I'm kind of just like, listen, I'm just ready to take this test. Like, I've been studying and honestly, I'm just ready to do it. Like, I don't know how to really explain it. Like, I just want to get it out the way. Not really get out the way, but like, actually, yeah, I want to get out the way. But I'm just at the point with this test where I just want to take it. Like, I have pushed it off due to anxiety so long, but now it's just like, I don't want this test controlling me anymore. That's just where I've reached to it. So yes, we are now officially starting exam day, which officially starts this vlog. I got a little, I don't know, I just feel ready. I feel a little nervous, but that's always going to be the case. But I don't feel like crippling nervous, if that makes sense. But we are going to, I don't know if I want to take a shower first or if I want to drink a cup of tea first. I'm actually not going to drink coffee, even though like I'm always drinking coffee like when I want to take a test, just because I don't want anything that can contribute to me like fidgeting, and coffee and caffeine definitely would make me bounce off the walls a little bit crazy, so I don't want to do that. I think I just want to drink a nice cup of tea, so I'm going to do that. I think I'm also gonna journal too, just to get any last minute doubts off my chest. And then I think I'm gonna get a shower and then we get ready. So come with me and let's do this. I'm gonna be using my special cup that I got from graduation. It said she believed she could, so she did. Kamai Han with an RN. Whenever I study or just feel like I need a little boost, I use that cup. I'm gonna drink peppermint tea this morning, just cause I really can't bother with the fidgeting that comes with caffeine. So this is my game day breakfast meal. I actually didn't want to eat this. I wanted to eat this, but instead of the milk, I wanted it with my yogurt. But my yogurt expired. Damn annoying yogurt. So I'm using a little almond milk, but this is my game day breakfast. And I think I'm about to relax for the next 30 minutes and watch something on TV. And then I'm going to get in the shower and get ready. But taking you guys along with me. Okay guys, so it's like 11:15. I'm about to have the next 15 minutes. I was watching like some comfort shows because I woke up super early. So I watched like Divergent and Coraline just to get my mind off of stuff. I'm still feeling pretty good. And I'm about to head out in like 15 minutes. I do have to drive like an hour and 15. So I am leaving out early to arrive like 12:45 since my test does start at 1. So I'm going to head out at 11:30. And emotions right now, anxiety is in check. I'm not really thinking about ahead. I just am focusing on going in there, doing what I gotta do, and knowing what I know, because I do know I know it. And hope for the best after. So we're about to head out, and hopefully everything goes as planned or expected, or whatever the case may be. We're hoping for the best, expecting the worst, but we're gonna do
fine. You sent me a little text message to tell me that she wishes me good luck, and I really needed this. I'm like, thanks babes. On my way now. because I'm on my way now. And honestly, I'm very disrespectful with this button. We're gonna notify it anyways.
Two hours later.
Okay guys, so I just came back out testing center. I just took my test and I'm having some mixed feelings because on one hand I think I did pretty good, on the other it's like I'm not too sure, because like my test I did get a lot of SATA questions and I did get some maternity, I did get some psych, I got it pretty much of everything. But I kept getting these questions about like infections and I'm like, damn, I know for a fact they cued in on that, because I'm the whole infection stuff, like that is the ones I really have to think about, like psych and stuff and maternity. I can just like, all right, I know that, like infections are a bit like kind of on the edge for me type of thing. But I don't think I did terrible. And another thing is I was the last one to go in and I was the first one out. And I felt like when I was doing the questions, I was really doing like, I was answering my questions based off of knowledge and I was answering them based off of common sense. So I feel like I did pretty good. But now it's always just that thought of like, damn, like what the hell? Like maybe, you know, I'm feeling that little kind of anxiety coming on, like, damn, what if I didn't do as well as I think I did? But like, I don't know. And that's another thing too. I got it to 145 questions. And the last time I took this test, I failed that 145 questions. So now I did get a little like anxious over that, but at the end of the day, I didn't really sweat it, just because same amount of people that pass in 75 can fail at 75 and vice versa. So I'm not really worried about that as much as at first I was. I'm more so just wondering like how well I did. And it is a Friday, so I just might have to wait until Tuesday to get my results, and I really hope that that's not the case, because I can't wait that long for these results. Like I need to know now. Like this is worse than taking a pregnancy test, if I'm honest with y'all. It's worse than that. Like it has more anxiety than a pregnancy test. And honestly, I just hope everything goes well. Like I feel like me failing my test and me going through what I was going through for like the past 3 months, this whole experience has been very humbling, and I'm honestly completely over it. Like, I'm just ready to be a nurse again. Like, I miss working in the hospital so much. Like, so much. And I'm just hoping and praying that everything went well. Like, oh gosh. But I'm a little worried. Now the 48 hours of waiting commences.
24 hours later.
Guys, it's officially 24 hours after I took my test. This is 24 hours. I did do the Pearson view trick just because, like, I don't know. I just wanted to see, but I thought it would give me, like, less anxiety. It kind of did, but it's kind of like, what if that's wrong? Because I did the Pearson view trick, and I actually got a good pop-up saying our records indicate that you already scheduled the exam, yada, yada, yada. And last time I took my test, I did do the Pearson view trick and I did try to charge my card and I definitely did fail. So I got the good pop-up, but part of me is still, I don't know, this test is just like, it just takes away every form of confidence I could ever have. Cause I just feel like if I get too hype, I'm gonna be bamboozled, like, ah, you're just that one person that, yeah, no, yeah. So I'm just kind of like, all right, that's a good pop-up. But I'm like, let me not get too excited. So yeah, that's where I'm at right now. I'm still a little nervous, but if I go off of logics and how the thing is, I would say I passed my NCLEX, but I can't just yet. I need to see that hardcore evidence. Like, you cannot trick me anymore. Like, that's where I'm at right now.
24 hours later.
Okay guys, so it is the big day. My quick results are in. I'm about to put in the card number so I can purchase it. I can't even speak right now. I'm very all over the place. No joke, my heart is kind of racing right now. And yeah, so I'm putting in the information now. Yeah, my heart's in my hands right now. I don't know what to tell y'all. Until I get these results, I don't know what to tell y'all. So, ooh. Terrifying. All right, next. Thanks. Okay. So good. I really have to read this properly first. All right, this is, all right, July 8th. All right. Oh, I did pass. All right, I passed. Oh my God, oh my God. Oh my God, like, oh my God. Hold on, I have to call my grandma. I have to. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God, I passed. Oh my God, oh my God. Oh, thank you, God. Oh. Oh my God, Grandma, you gotta answer. Why y'all don't wanna answer me at this moment? This is the moment you need to answer.
Hi,
Grandma.
Hi, baby.
I passed my NCLEX.
You're so happy.
I really am happy.
I am happy for you.
I passed.
I'm afraid about it.
Good. I'm so excited. I wanted to know my results first before I called you.
I'm so happy for you.
I know, like, it feels like a weight has been lifted off my chest.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Oh my gosh. I read it like 5 times. I'm like, all right, it says pass.
Pass, thank God. Congratulations.
Oh my God, I can't stop smiling.
That's good. I'm glad.
Oh, I can tell mom. I can't wait to tell mom. Yeah, I'm like really, 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 really happy. I can't stop smiling. I'm gonna call my mom because she has to see this. I can't believe it. Oh my God. Like, I really did it, y'all. Hi, mom.
Hi, daughter.
How are you on this beautiful day?
Stressed out.
You're stressed out?
Did you pass your test?
Yes, I did pass my test.
Congratulations.
I read it like 5 times. I was like, all right, does it say pass? It says pass.
Yes.
Look at it. Look. It says it. You see it?
Yeah. Thank God.
Hello.
Hi.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
I know you did it. I know you was hungry for it. You was vexed the first time. I know you will do it. Don't worry. I did believe in you.
Thank
so
you.
Your mom.
Thank you.
We know you could do it, you know, but I think you made a mistake when you wait that long and then you put down the book on. Yeah, but at least we are there now. Congratulations. We gonna celebrate, okay?
Okay.
Okay. From the see that invitation, I know that one, so I know from yesterday. I was telling you from yesterday. That's good.
I can't believe it. I keep reading it to make sure it still says pass. I'm like, okay. Hi, Auntie Camille.
Hi, Kimaya.
Guess what, Auntie Camille?
What, Kimaya? I passed my NCLEX. I did it. I got the results. I read it. It says passed. I read it like 10 times. I passed.
I told you. You needed to just relax and just chill. You got this, mama.
I did it. Like, I can't believe it. I keep reading it like. Like, I'm just.
Girl.
I feel like a weight has been lifted off my chest with this one.
Yeah.
Like, I've been.
So we rich.
We rich. I'm excited. Oh my gosh. I'm so excited.
Now you can get the job that you want.
Yes. I have it lined up. Resume already ready. I gotta write my cover letter and I'm submitting it.
There you go.
I'm not even playing. I'm gonna do this. Oh my gosh.
Congratulations, mama. I'm proud of you.
Hi.
Hey.
How are you?
Good, how are you?
I'm good. I have something to tell you.
What's up?
I passed my NCLEX. I did it. I've been looking at this thing like 12 times and I keep reading over like, okay, it says pass. All right, pass.
Let me see.
I did it.
Yeah,
you see it? Oh my God. I can't stop smiling. I'm so glad it's over.
You're like an RN.
Yeah. I can't believe it. Like, I feel like I can't even let the screen close. I'm like, let me keep watching it. Like, it says pass. Like, I can't believe it.
I'm so happy.
And I'm not gonna lie, I finished that test mad quick. Like, I got there because it's like 5 hours or 6 hours, something like that. And I was done 5 minutes after it offered me my break. Like,
how many questions did it ask you?
I did the whole thing. I did the whole 145. And people love saying that, oh, if you can do 145, that means you automatically fail. That's not true. Last time I did 145, I did fail, but this time I passed.
I learned that the more questions you get here, that means that, like, you're doing better. Because, like, it tells you what fast you're going to do that.
I'm so happy. Oh my God, I'm excited. Like, I want a drink. Like, I swear I'm ready for a drink right now.